Imagine you have reached the last round of your cloud engineer or cloud DevOps interview, and the scenario is given to you wherein the interviewer asks that we are trying to migrate a payment service from on-prem to cloud, and this service needs to be highly efficient in managing multiple transactions per second. Also, it has to be highly resilient and secure at the same time. What would be your top choices for choosing the operating system for your microservices architecture? And by default, you will say, I'll choose Linux operating system. Okay, yes, we know you will choose Linux operating system because it is what everything is running on right now. But which flavor you would prefer? And that is the catch, because we do tend to work with multiple flavors, but we do not understand the applicability of those distributions or those flavors, where it can be used, what are the best case scenarios. And while there are so many, in this video we'll talk about six Linux distributions which every cloud engineer must know. So going ahead, the number one. So on the left, we have the enterprise kings. So enterprise kings means that these flavors are mostly used in enterprise scenarios. So the number one, and I will correlate it with some cars which are very famous in India to pass on the analogy. So this one is our Maruti Suzuki Swift, because this is what almost every Indian drives, and this Linux operating system is what everyone uses. It is very easy, it is very user friendly, it is available, it is free. Swift is not free, this is free to use. And the flavor is, and you might have guessed it by the initials, so this is Ubuntu. So Ubuntu should be your first go-to choice. Everything in cloud when you are spinning up starts with Ubuntu. Okay, it is very easy to understand. It has a massive support online, a community which is very strong, and it is free to use. So anyone who is starting their journey on Linux should start from Ubuntu. Coming to our second enterprise choice, this is Toyota Innova. You might have seen in IT industries, whenever the client visits are there, you know, they are generally using Toyota Innova. For corporate customers, they do not send Maruti Suzuki Swift, and that is what this particular version is. Because when you are talking about enterprise use cases for big customers like ICICI, HDFC, big banks which need security, which needs proper support, then you need to go for a paid version of this distribution flavor, which is RHEL, Red Hat Enterprise Linux. This is very, very strong in terms of security. It also comes with 10 years of support. If you want, there is a regular patching happening, but obviously it is not free, and it is very heavy in terms of its overall performance and robustness. And if you are an architect, or if you are an enterprise architect or cloud architect working for big enterprise customers, then you would always want to go with something which is highly reliable, although it will come with some cost. So this is our Red Hat Enterprise Linux, a very good distribution flavor for enterprise use cases. The last one is our Ambassador. So Ambassador nowadays are not seen that much, but when it comes to old school thinking, when it comes to high reliability and robustness and strength, Ambassador always wins the race, especially with people who are from older generation. They always love their Ambassador cars, and that's what is giving to us by Debian. So Debian is generally used by old school sysadmins, Linux admins, because they still feel that Debian offers all the necessary packages and libraries and everything which are required for a Linux kernel, and that's why Debian is very trustworthy. But the downside is that it will not have the latest updates coming very frequently. Okay, if there are latest features or latest add-ons which are coming, it would come first to these flavors. Debian would be left behind in that sense. So now let's go to our next category, which are called the specialists. Why they are specialists? Because they are used for special use cases. And the fourth in our list is our favorite Tata Nano. Why Tata Nano is famous? Tata Nano is small. Tata Nano is very lightweight. It can go and get parked in the clumsiest of streets. And that's what you need. If you want to get somewhere very quickly, you need a car which is small enough, lightweight, does not cost you a huge amount of money. That's what is the distribution Alpine Linux gives you. So it can be deployed with a size of as low as 5 MB. So in a distributed microservices architecture, if you want to make it really lightweight, and if you want to spin up your containers with a very lightweight operating system which just does the job and have bare minimum requirements to spin up Docker container from a Docker image, then Alpine Linux is your go-to choice, because it is really lightweight, hassle-free, and very quick to spin up. Obviously, it will have its downside if you need very robust performance, but if you need a very easy to go, lightweight distribution, then Alpine Linux should be your choice. The fifth one in our list is pre-owned Innova. Now, you might get confused why we are talking about pre-owned Innova. Because if you don't have Innova and if you don't have money for Innova, you can go for Innova which is pre-owned, which might be cheaper, and that's what provides Rocky, and these are two different flavors, Alma Linux. So there's a history behind it. When Red Hat Linux was used, a proper choice if you don't want to use Red Hat Linux was CentOS, but then later on CentOS was discontinued and another flavor came into the market which is called CentOS Stream, but that was not well received. But whereas Rocky and Alma Linux, these came as a freer version of Red Hat Enterprise Linux. So both these versions have very good compatibility, and obviously these are open source and free to use. So if you want to have something which can be a descendant or a right predecessor for Red Hat Enterprise Linux, then you need to go for Rocky and Alma Linux. So very good use case for using Rocky and Alma Linux is that if you have Red Hat Linux in your production systems and you want cheaper version of the same kind of a flavor in your dev environment, then you can go for Rocky and Alma Linux for your dev environment or test environment, because it would have direct compatibility with your production and it would also save you some money. Last but definitely not the least is Thar, Mahindra Thar. Okay, now why I'm calling this flavor a Thar is because of the fact that it might not be a perfect family car, but when it comes to going into high terrains, dense forest or a safari or some ride which is very risky, then Thar is something which you want to go in with. You don't want to drive your Nano or your Swift into a desert safari, right? So Thar is not for every use case, but a very specific use case, and that is what Kali Linux also does. So Kali Linux is a perfect distribution for cybersecurity use cases, for penetration testings, for all your security engineers, cloud security engineers, everyone who wants to start using cybersecurity and implement cybersecurity, they always go for Kali Linux, because Kali Linux have all the tools and the packages which are required for cybersecurity use cases. But it is not for using everywhere. It is very, very specific, for example, pen testing. Okay, so Kali Linux is your Thar. You can't drive it, and you should not be going with Thar to buy vegetables, although you are free to do so. So that's what Kali Linux is, very, very specific use case, but yes, very important. So these six are very, very important, but the most important thing is where you're gonna deploy it. All these Linux environments are gonna go on a cloud environment more often than not. And if you're new to cloud, or if you want to start your journey on AWS cloud, there's something very interesting in the description. Go check it out. We have built something which will definitely jumpstart your career on cloud. So go check the link in the description. Also, there is a free guide which talks about all the AWS 128 AWS services, in a single line or two lines, which will be very handy for your interviews. So go check it out, download it, it's free. So with this, we come to an end of this video. I hope you liked it. If yes, then don't let me get replaced by an AI video, and give me a like and a subscribe. It will help me. And not only give me a like or subscribe, give every teacher who's putting in the efforts teaching you across YouTube, give them a lot of love, support and heart. Okay, so with that, signing off. Keep learning, keep sharing, keep growing. Bye for now.